MLinkPlanner is an all-in-one solution for microwave link planning and optimization. In this video, I will demonstrate the main features of MLinkPlanner. For more details, refer to the user manual on our website mlinkplanner.com. When you start the program, a new project is automatically created. Basemap appears on the right side of the panel. You can select one of the preset basemaps or configure your own custom basemap by specifying a title server URL. Map navigation is performed with a mouse. Use the mouse wheel to zoom the map in or out. You can also choose the map scale from a drop-down menu next to the map name. When the map is zoomed in to the level 12 or higher, the application begins to download SRTM elevation data and tree cover data. The status bar will display the pointer's geographic coordinates and the information about the elevation above sea level and the height of the trees, if any. To create sites, go to the Sites tab and enter the name of sites and coordinates in any format. An easier way is to right-click on the right place on basemaps and use the context menu to create a new site. The name can be then changed. Sites can be deleted or moved up or down in the list. You can also import sites into MLinkPlanner from any spreadsheet through CSV file. After creating sites, you can create hubs. You need to switch to the Hubs tab. Use the right mouse button to select sites at the end of the hubs. If necessary, the location of the sites can be changed right here on the base map. After the link is created, you can immediately build its path profile. On the Hubs tab, select a hub in the top hub table, then go to the Profile tab of that hub and click Generate Profile. You should specify the average building floor height, typically 3 meters, in this window. That is because the OSM project database usually contains information about the number of floors of the buildings rather than its height in meters. Therefore, building height in the path profile will be based on the number of floors and floor height. You will also have to specify the height of the buildings for which the OSM project database does not have information. Such buildings will be highlighted in red in the path profile if the building affects the qualitative characteristics of the hub as a critical clutter. Check the building's height with the third-party sources. The user can override the forest height information obtained from the global forest change records and set a new value to be used in the path profile. Then click OK, and after a couple of seconds, the information about terrain elevation and clutter characteristics along the path profile will appear in the table cells. The view of the path profile will be displayed at the top right of the panel. If you select a segment on the path profile with the mouse button, the segment will also be selected in the elevation table, clutter table, and on the base map. The application allows you to create a path profile by manually specifying all elevations and clutters on the path. MLinkPlanner can calculate the height of the main and diversity antennas using the clearance criteria described in the recommendation ITUR P530. To calculate the minimum antenna height, click an icon next to the desired antenna. In the window that opens, specify the optimization parameters. The height of the response antenna will be fixed at the current value. Once the required preferences are selected, click Calculate Antenna Height and the minimum antenna height will appear on the right. The path profile image will display the criterion used to calculate the antenna height. Click OK to change the antenna height according to the calculated value. To discard the calculated value, click Cancel. The parameters and equipment configuration for each of the sites are specified in the Site A and Site B tabs. You can enter the radio parameters manually or import them from the REV format files that I used to describe the equipment in the path loss program. MLinkPlanner supports any equipment configuration and diversity technique. On this tab, you need to specify your approach to determining the reliability of the microwave line and, if necessary, enter additional parameters to calculate the performance and availability objectives. MLinkPlanner calculates path reliability and outage in accordance with the model recommended in the ITUR P530. To start calculation, click Report and a calculation report will come up. You can switch between the shoot report view and the full report view. The short report displays only calculation results. The full report displays input parameters, calculation results, path profile drawing, and path profile diagram on the map. You can print the report or save it as PDF, Microsoft Word, or Excel. Reflection analysis allows the user to identify possible specular reflection points on the hop and evaluate the application of various specular reflection reduction methods. Diffraction analysis allows the user to estimate diffraction losses due to the obstacles on the hop. Diffraction losses may be caused by inability to meet the clearance criteria as per recommendation ITUR P530. For more details, refer to the user manual on our website, mlinkplanner.com.